Hello, everyone. My name is Magnus McCune. I am a principal architect in the office of the CTO here at HiveMQ. We are regularly asked what a unified namespace looks like in practice, so today I will be walking you through a quick demo. At its core, the unified namespace allows us to bring together data from across the organization, contextualize it into business information, and generate derived, actionable insights, all while maintaining data integrity. Let's have a look at our demo environment where I have a representative UNS up and running. For the purposes of this demo, I'm going to be talking about a car manufacturer. Let's imagine a car manufacturer who's historically used equipment that might connect via protocols like OPC UA or Modbus, and they're looking to digitalize their plants and implement a unified namespace. I'm showing here a multi-site system in which I have two factories, factory one and factory two, that are all publishing their data across to a centralized broker, that HiveMQ Cloud in this case, which is then connected to additional data systems. So once again, persisting that data across to our data lake, being used for business intelligence purposes to create reports, publishing across to a database that is then used for machine learning inferences, which is able to publish those inferences back into HiveMQ and potentially all the way back down to the edge. That cloud broker really becomes that central point of integration for the entire enterprise, that single source of truth for all operational data within the organization. Let's look now at what that unified namespace topic structure looks like. This tree view shows me my root node, which is effectively global industries, so the name of my organization. And we can see that this is quite a busy topic structure. And so we have new data points being published regularly. It's quite a large data structure and a little bit unwieldy. So we'll have a look at it in our UNS Explorer. This UNS Explorer allows me to walk through my unified namespace in a structured way. So let's have a look at Munich, and let's go to this body shop. So this follows an ISA 95 style representation of a unified namespace, where I'm going from enterprise, site, and then an area. So in this case, the body shop area. And let's have a look at the welding robot line. And in particular, let's have a look at this welding robot 005. So I can see there's some telemetry here. So that would be like a raw namespace where I'm receiving data directly from these systems. I have a set of alarms that allows me to see alarms as they're coming in. And I have an information topic. So this is like an informational namespace that might have information about that specific welding robot. So manufacturer and a serial number and that sort of thing. And then actually this just populated for us. So we have a predictive maintenance, which is like a functional namespace. So this is a namespace that is actually providing a specific function. And within that predictive maintenance, we're making some sort of prediction about how this particular device is operating. So I could navigate it this way, but we wanted to make this demo a little more interactive. And so we built something we like to call the UNS Bot. The UNS Bot is not a product from HiveMQ. This is just a fun way to demo what you might be able to do with the unified namespace. So once you have this data available to you, what could you build? And so this is effectively a large language model that allows me to query against my unified namespace and have it respond to me in specific ways. Dude, we just explored that Munich namespace and specifically the body shop and welding robots. Let's ask a question about that. So the question I'm asking is, can you tell me the rejected quantity of items in Munich's body shop for the welding line? And I'm asking it to show some of its homework. So let's see what it gives me. And so it's providing me the path first. So it said, hey, I started at the root node. I've navigated through to global industries, Munich, body shop, welding robots. And we're looking for production information. And so our manufacturing execution system happens to have that. So it's gone to our manufacturing execution system and it looked for a rejected quantity value. And it's indicating that this is 7. So I have 7 rejected parts. So this gives us a really interactive way of querying our unified namespace. This is intended to give you an idea of how you might build data systems around this. Okay, thank you so much for joining me on this exploration of a unified namespace. We appreciate your time and we look forward to speaking with you on the subject. Thank you so much.